हाई स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज दैट इज ईथर्स, दैट इज आर ओ आर. जनरली ईथर्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स. फ्रेंड्स, ईथर्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स, दैट इज सिंपल ईथर्स एंड सेकंड वन इज मिक्स्ड ईथर्स. सिंपल ईथर्स एंड मिक्स्ड ईथर्स. What is simple ether? What is mixed ether? Simple ether means that is same type of alkyl groups, same type of alkyl groups attached to the oxygen, that is called simple ethers. What is the mixed ether? Mixed ether means different types of alkyl groups, when different type of alkyl groups attached to the oxygen, that is called mixed ether. Now take the example for mixed ether. What I said, example of simple ether. Simple ether, for example, that is same type of alkyl groups or methyl groups attached to the oxygen, that is called simple ether. Example, that is dimethyl ether or dimethyl ether or diethyl ether. That is same type of alkyl group means methyl groups. These both methyl groups are attached to the oxygen, that is called simple ethers. What about mixed ethers? Mixed ethers means different types of alkyl groups attached to the oxygen. So that is called mixed ether. Now take the example, one methyl group and one ethyl group attached to the oxygen. That's what is called mixed ethers. One is left hand side is methyl group is there, right hand side is ethyl group is there. These both are different, so that's why it is called mixed ethers. Mixed ethers groups, ethers symbol, that is ROR. So R means alkyl groups, that is methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl, like that. So here same kind of alkyl group attached to the oxygen, that is called simple ether. Mixed ether means what I said, student, that is different types of alkyl groups, one methyl group and one ethyl groups attached to the oxygen. So that's why it is called mixed ether. Generally this oxygen having two lone pairs, both oxygen having two lone pairs, student. This is the simple trick, student. So what are the conditions for ethers, student? Generally ethers can be prepared at low temperature, students. What are the conditions for preparation of ether? It is also very, very most important, students. What are the conditions? That is low temperature, and second condition, that is, and less hindered or less crowded, example. And third one, student, that is ethers undergo generally SN2 mechanism. This is the very, very most important condition, students. So this is the conditions for ethers, student. That is, condition is ethers can be prepared at low temperature, student. And second condition is ethers can be prepared from this less hindered compound. That means methyl bromide, ethyl chloride, ethyl, like that. That is alkyl halide means methyl chloride, ethyl chloride, like that. And generally this ethers undergoes SN2 mechanism, student. This is the simple trick for ethers conditions, student. So one by one I will discuss, that is one by one, student. So how to prepare ethers? First, student, preparation of ethers. Now first one, preparation of ethers. Ethers ke example in writing brackets, ethers ke example, that is diethyl ether. How to prepare diethyl ether? Now first one is, that is ether prepared from alcohols. First preparation, from alcohols. Diethyl ether can be prepared from alcohols. What is the example, student? That is alcohol, that is ethyl alcohol. When ethyl alcohol, CH3, CH2OH. When ethyl alcohol react with concentrated H2SO4 at 140 degrees centigrade. At 140 degrees centigrade, student, it is very, very most important, student. First preparation, student, ethers can be prepared. That is, ether ke example is, that is diethyl ether. When diethyl ether can be prepared from alcohols, alcohols ke example take the student, that is ethyl alcohol. When ethyl alcohol react with concentrated H2SO4 at low temperature, that is 140 degrees centigrade, it gives diethyl ether will be formed. Student, that is diethyl ether will be formed. CH3, CH2O, CH2, then CH3. Plus water. This is called diethyl ether. When ethyl alcohol react with concentrated H2SO4 at 140 degree centigrade, it gives diethyl ether. This is the ether, that is O oxygen, diethyl ether plus water. In this reaction, so that is elimination, that is dehydration. In this reaction, so this reaction is a dehydration reaction, that is elimination. Dehydration means what I said, so dehydration, that is removal of water. In this reaction, removal of water. But in this production, in this product, here total 4 carbons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are there, student. But in this reactant, only 2 carbons are there. How can it is possible, student? Product component having 4 carbons are there, but reactant molecule only 2 carbons are there. How can it is possible, student? So we should take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. So you remember, student? Take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. When 2 moles of ethyl alcohol react with concentrated H2SO4 at 140 degree centigrade, it gives diethyl ether plus water will be formed. So this is the simple trick, student. 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. Simple, I am writing, student. Ethyl alcohol we can write like this: CH3, CH2, OH plus CH3, CH2, OH. Like this, sorry, plus take the, I am writing similar to this one, student. Here 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, I am taking one by one. So here also 1 mole ethyl alcohol, here also 1 mole ethyl alcohol. This both are combining, student. This is ethyl alcohol. Take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, I am writing clearly. CH3CH2OH 1 mole, CH3CH2 1 mole. So what happens, student, in this reaction, concentrated H2SO4 act as a dehydrating agent. Dehydrating means what, student? Removal of water. Dehydrating means what, student? Removal of water. So here OH group taking from here, student. OH group taking from here. One hydrogen taking from here. Simple, you remember, student. Here take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. It is also 1 mole of ethyl alcohol. It is also 1 mole of ethyl alcohol. Complete OH group taking from here. One hydrogen taking from here. Remaining component. What is the remaining production? Here CH3, CH2O. Then CH2CH, the simple I am writing CH3, and first product having, student, that is CH3CH2, O is there, then bond, after that here CH2CH3, this is the simple trick, student. These both are similar, student. So take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, react with concentrated H2SO4 at 140 degree centigrade, it gives diethyl ether plus water. These both are same, student. I clearly explained that 2 moles, how can it is possible 2 moles, here also 1 mole of ethyl alcohol, here also 1 mole of ethyl alcohol. So in this, what is the role of concentrated H2SO4, student? This concentrated H2SO4 act as a dehydrating agent. Rehydrating means what, student? Removal of water. So here out of these 2 ethyl alcohol groups, one OH group taking from this alcohol, one hydrogen taking from this alcohol. So we get, that is diethyl ether will be formed. This is the simple trick, student. This is the preparation of diethyl ether from alcohol, student. Now second method, student, from ethyl alcohol. When ethyl alcohol react with aluminum trioxide Al2O3 at 260 degree centigrade, it is also giving same type of product will be formed, student, that is diethyl ether will be formed. CH3CH2O CH2CH3 plus water. Here also same thing, student, but here the reagents are different, student. This is very, very most important, student. When ethyl alcohol takes the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 at 140, it gives diethyl ether will be formed, student. At the same time, here also same thing, student. Take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. When take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, here take the 2 moles, student. Take the 2 moles of ethyl alcohol, react with Al2O3 at 260 degree centigrade. It is also giving same type of product will be formed, that is diethyl ether will be formed. This is a simple trick for preparation of diethyl ether from alcohol. So this is a simple trick, student. Now take the one more, second, third preparation method, student. Third preparation method, that is from ethyl chloride, that is from one second, that is from ethyl chloride, that is, and CH3CH2Cl, when ethyl chloride react with silver oxide Ag2O, when silver oxide should on heating student, when ethyl chloride react with silver oxide to use, it is also giving same type of product will be formed. So diethyl ether will be formed, CH3CH2O, then CH2, then CH3 plus 2AgCl will be formed. This is the simple reaction. Here also same thing student, take the 2 moles of ethyl chloride, react with silver oxide. What happens student, that is, this is the, in this reaction student, that is AgCl, take the 2 moles of ethyl chloride, react with Ag2O. What happens student, that is diethyl ether will be formed plus 2AgCl will be formed student. Here elimination, AgCl is elimination student, simple. Here take the 2 moles of AgCl is elimination, remaining product same thing student, there 2 moles of ethyl group is there, 1 oxygen is, both are combining to form diethyl ether plus AgCl will be formed. So this is the simple trick for preparation of diethyl ether. So these are the preparation of ether. Now next one more preparation, so that is one more preparation students, ethers can be prepared from Williamson synthesis student. Williamson synthesis, it is very 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 most important for named reaction student. From Williamson synthesis student, diethyl ether or ethers can be prepared from Williamson synthesis. What is the Williamson synthesis? When alkyl halide, when alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide, it is very very most important student. When alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide, you remember student, when alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide in the presence of dry ether, to give ether will be formed, this is the simple question. When alkyl halide, means example student, what is the example student, that is alkyl halide example, that is RX, when RX react with sodium alkoxide, that means RONA, in the presence of dry ether, it use ethers will be formed, ROR plus NaX will be formed. This is the simple trick, that is Williamson synthesis means what I said, that is when alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide in the presence of dry ether to give ether will be formed. This is a simple trick. Now take the example for as Williamson synthesis, example that is alkyl halide example, that is CH3CH2Cl, ethyl chloride react with sodium ethoxide, that is CH3CH2ONa, that is sodium ethoxide. It is alkyl halide, it is sodium ethoxide, it is a strong base, strong nucleophile, it gives diethyl ether will be formed, CH3CH2O CH2CH3 plus NaCl. This is the simple trick student. So this is primary alkyl halide, when primary alkyl halide react with strong base, it follow the SN2 mechanism student, that is the strong base, that is strong nucleophile favor the SN2 mechanism student, you remember student, in a Williamson synthesis, it follow the SN2 mechanism student. So this is primary alkyl halide, that is CH3CH2Cl, in the presence of strong base, it gives diethyl ether will be formed. So this is the simple trick for ether students. Ethers generally classified into two types, so that is simple ethers and mixed ether. Simple ethers means same kind of alkyl group is called simple ether. Mixed ethers means different kind of alkyl groups attached to the oxygen is called mixed ether student, this is a simple trick for NEET and JEE and other competitive exam student. If you like my video, please like, share and comment, and thanks for watching student. Thank you.